I mean, we could just go into it this next conversation. Marvel released their lineup today. And it was interesting because it was in complete, you know, reaction to what DC did on Monday. I looked at the DC. So here's my train of thought. Like, sit down. Everybody's sitting down, right? Okay, good. So my train of thought of how this went. We talked a couple weeks ago about Flash. You guys said, before you watch Flash, make sure you watch Get Caught Up with Arrow. I said, all right. So I started watching Arrow. They show me the first inkling of Flash. I say, oh, I can't wait. So I watch the first episode of Flash while I'm still watching Arrow. I am loving both of what I'm getting. But in watching Arrow, I start to get hints, which make me interested in a lot of stuff that I saw that DC's deciding to release. And I'm thinking, do I really care? I think there was this great argument or discussion that I listened to where I think we're getting overload of the, like, part of me says this is cool because as a kid, I loved reading comic books, you know? So this is just the video version of the comic books. I like movies. The other part saying, is this overload? And then with Marvel's lineup, is this extreme overload? Will there... Like, I know it's going to come down to basically the people that aren't fanboys of either of these, and that's what's going to determine, like, how this then ventures forward. But I feel like having this lineup so far in advance is kind of weird. I think it's the, you know, the spark interest, but I don't know. Like, what do you guys think? Like, were you guys excited about this? Does DC... I mean, I understand Marvel, DC are different identities, but, like, I don't care about the Wonder Woman movie. I have no interest in that. I think they're going to mess up Batman, Superman. The Justice League should have come first, like, before we started, or, like, I don't know. It's just so weird. There's, it's not Gangster Squad. What's the other movie?
Suicide Squad.
That's the one that I got... The interest got sparked when I was watching Arrow, and I was like, oh, all right, that could be interesting. But here's my comparison between that. Suicide Squad should have come out way before a Justice League, right? And based on their lineup, it's not. And I feel like that the Suicide Squad is in comparison to Guardians, and we already had Avengers. And well, that's not even the big blockbuster action heroes.
Do we even know that Suicide Squad is in the same universe? Because I haven't read anywhere that it is. And the same thing of like, see, the thing is of Marvel. Marvel released their big schedule today. They have Civil War in 2016. They have Doctor Strange in 2016. Guardians 2, Thor 3, and Black Panther in 2017, which is awesome. Then you have Captain Marvel, Avengers Infinity War Part 1 in 2018, and Inhumans in 2018, and then the end of Avengers Infinity War in 2019. That seems like they have a specific plan, and they know what they're doing with it, because you can even see the bits of Inhumans being started on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., because their stuff is all intricately tied in. Mm-hmm. DC... like it's throwing shit at a wall and seeing what sticks.
When you think about the sheer amount of, like, here, I guess what like just makes me sit back and like kind of say, how's this all gonna fall into place? If any of these movies, all right, for first question, if DC manages to mess up something, all right, do you think that the negative effect of whatever DC does will linger onto a Marvel movie?
If nothing else, it makes Marvel look that much better.
Yep. If anything else, it's going to increase the gross of Marvel.
Exactly.
Avengers probably made more money because a lot of people didn't like Dark Knight Rises.
I think the issue here is, like, we have Marvel, who has a proven track record, and they're like, well, here's a plan. We came out 2 years ago and laid out the plan of, like, you got Thor Dark World, you got a Captain America Winter Soldier, you know, Avengers is going to be Age of Ultron, and they stuck to the plan. And they have a track record, and they took something like Guardians of the Galaxy and they made it a hit. Everybody wants a Baby Groot doll now, for instance, right? Spoilers.
Yep.
But DC is like, well, that Man of Steel, like, Man of Steel was not a collectively celebrated movie to the effect of any of the Marvel movies have been at all. True. Like, too many people are like, this is not my Superman. Like, this isn't, there's a difference between that's my Superman that I read in the comic to that feels like the Superman that I read in the comic, or that feels like the Superman I know from Christopher Reeves, right?
Or even Tom Welling.
And the problem is, I think the problem is the properties are too big for them to handle, and they continually have dropped the ball or got okay-ish with the ball in the case of the last Batman series, right? I mean, I still don't, the Batman series, as good of movies as those are not a good soup, got not, they're the best Batman movie we can get, but they're not the best Batman movie we would deserve.
I don't even think it's the best Batman movie we can get. I would direct I would direct you to the animated full-length version of Dark Knight Returns.
Okay, the animation's completely separate. Where Marvel is awesome in the studio thing, I think they're kind of subpar in a lot of their animation efforts, a couple of series excluded, but they're like, the movies they were doing straight to DVD for a long time were so bad. DC have just got it locked down. They have their section, but, you know, we were talking a little bit before the show about how messed up Hollywood is. This is WB is messed up. That studio I was telling you about, that Pee Wee Herman needed to go on a 21 or 20 some cities tour to prove that he was still relevant because they didn't have HBO in LA to get Big Adventure. That was Warner Brothers.
Of course it was.
So, I mean, Warner Brothers is not they're not a level-headed movie studio that has somebody like a Kevin Feige that can say, we're doing this, this, and this, and can put all those pieces into place.
You need, like, a DC Studios.
Exactly. That's exactly good what enough. You need. You need comic book people to step up and say, we're going to do boom, boom, boom. You need Jeff Johns to head up this stuff. Look at what he's been doing with the shows. I mean, I once again, we have the compartment of the cartoons doing really awesome. We were talking about, you know, Arrow and Flash with you, Malenko. You know, those are doing pretty amazing right now, right? DC is kind of an interesting experiment. Or, I'm sorry, Gotham's kind of an interesting experiment, but still way better than a lot of other attempts. I would say Gotham, even if you don't think it's the best thing ever, still better than the last, like, average of five last DC superhero movies that came out.
Oh yeah, like I enjoy Gotham better than Batman Begins.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like Gotham as much as a lot of other people do.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's just an odd track record. That's why we're kind of scratching our heads when we see this massive, we got a plan, just like Marvel. It's like, we came out with the Zune, just like the iPod. It really is.
Well, see, the problem is when they made that announcement, like, Marvel made their announcement today, it's literally all Marvel movies. When DC made the announcement, they're like, hey, we're doing
Batman,
Superman, and Fantastic Beasts, and Lego.
Because, like, it's a Warner Brothers announcement, it's not a DC announcement.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I was definitely thrown off by Suicide Squad because of that. I already talked about that. Like I said, Wonder Woman, I understand the appeal that some people have about Wonder Woman. I don't know that I would sit through a whole feature-length Wonder Woman movie. Well,
that's because we haven't seen what Gal Gadot is going to bring to it yet.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Like, in Marvel's slate that they're coming out with, they have one could-be-great, could-kind-of-bomb movie a year. Like, Doctor Strange is a completely new entity. We're not going to know what we get with that.
Yeah.
Black Panther in 2017, he's going to be in Civil War, but Black Panther, a movie by himself, is going to be a complete unknown entity.
The other random thing that, once we get into, like, the Civil War, these stories, like, it sucks because you know these stories are going to be limited by what by what they can portray on film. And like, there have been a lot of people upset with what happened with The Hobbit, that, you know, since what The Matrix did by splitting up the second and third movie, we've had that repeat. We had that with The Hobbit. We had that with
Harry Potter.
Harry Potter.
Yeah, Harry Potter and Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, but, so, I mean, and
in Hunger Games.
We've been seeing this trend. Yeah, Hunger Games. We've been seeing this trend. And, like, I just don't know if I'm going to be a fan of...
Well, Marvel's always splitting up one...
Mike, we lost your audio.
Oh.
You got so mad you knocked yourself off the internet. You're back, I think.
Okay.
Anger.
Marvel's only splitting up one movie. They're only splitting up the Infinity Gauntlet movie.
And to be safe, it's not a straight adaptation of a book.
Yeah.
Whereas every other case that you mentioned are adaptations of a book. For them, they're saying there is no way they're going to Sin City this and do a straight adaptation of the Infinity War. It is impossible because of the way the cinematic universe is presented. That's why we're having a Civil War. They mentioned the Civil War is not going to be based on identity. So, Mike, you talked about the Peter Parker angle with it. It wouldn't even be relevant in this version. Yeah. Age of Ultron looks nothing like what Age of Ultron was.
Disney's been talks, though, with Marvel. Disney. Who? Fox? Fox Sony. Is in talks.
Sony. Yeah. Sony's in talks with Marvel to send out Spider-Man as a loner. But honestly, I was thinking about it more after I made that comment last week. And with what you have going with the distrust in the government and in S.H.I.E.L.D.
Exactly.
That's the way you can go with it. That is exactly the way you can go with it, because you can have Captain America not wanting to be part of S.H.I.E.L.D. You can have him siding with the U.S. government. Like, hell, I would love if Captain America became like the Secretary of Defense or the Secretary of Department of Homeland Security or something like that. Something to the point where he's like, we need to get these superheroes in line because of after the events of Age of Ultron, we need everything happening.
Hmm. Yeah, I mean, that would be a compelling story. Like I said, this is our childhood. This is basically the pages that we read on paper coming, you know, full circle to the big screen. So
it just feels like Marvel has a plan.
Yeah.
They connect everything. If the DC movies were connecting with their TV shows, like if their Gotham was eventually leading into what would become Ben Affleck's Batman.
Yeah.
Or if Grant Gustin and Stephen Amell were going to be in the Justice League movie, I would have way more faith in DC.
Yeah, no, I totally agree. The fact that we're getting a completely different Flash.
The fact that Green Arrow's not even going to be in the Justice League.
Yeah, the fact that we're seeing a Flash and Aquaman before we see the first part one of Justice League, I think is completely weird.
It's backwards. I mean, there's no build. That's my problem. There's no build. Like, I don't want another origin story from these guys. But then again, and I think the other difference is how many origin stories have you seen of all the people listed on that WB list, right? How many origin stories have you seen of Iron Man, Captain America, Thor, etc.? You haven't. You haven't. Yeah. You know, cartoon to cartoon, sure. But even that, I think those characters aren't as overexposed as WB's.
Well, to be fair, I wouldn't mind seeing a Wonder Woman origin story.
I wouldn't mind either, but...
Because I have yet... The only version of a Wonder Woman origin story I've seen that's actually intrigued me is what they did in the Smallville comic.
Mm-hmm.
Other than that, I'm interested to see what a movie version of that is like. But apart from that, I mean... Is Batman versus Superman going to be kind of the intro for everyone? Because that's what it seems like.
Must be.
Maybe. I mean, if they base it on the animated movie, they could.
Just go on. They're not basing anything off anything at this point.
Yeah.
What in the movies really took off of anything in the comics? I know there's one story it did kind of, but not really. So,
even. Oh, Zack Snyder. I looked up Zack Snyder's movies and I realized that I didn't like any of them. On top of that, why are we bringing back Green Lantern?
It's probably not going to be Hal Jordan.
No. Hopefully.
Like I had said when we were talking about before on the Facebook group, DC would have to announce like Idris Elba as Jon Stewart, just to get some sort of excitement for something down the line, because they announced who's playing Black Panther and it's Chadwick Boseman, the guy who played Jackie Robinson in 42, and that was who I was dreaming they would cast as T'Challa, and that he's going to be really, really good, and I'm super excited about that. And he's going to be showing up in Civil War. So there's Wakanda is going to have an influence on the Marvel Civil War, and I'm very amped about that.
Which is a big aspect from the comic book for those that haven't
read. Oh, yeah, that's huge. Like, and I think the Age of Ultron trailer showed Andy Serkis, who most people think that he's playing Ulysses Klaue, which is the Black Panther's main villain. So if that's going to be how we tie into Civil War and how that bleeds over into a Black Panther movie, bravo. They're planting the seeds for a movie in 2017 in a trailer released in 2014. That's how on the ball Marvel is about this. That's how much they're planning ahead.
It's patience. Certainly. It feels like because we on Panel Riot, I know the discussion. Will, what does he go by on there? He has been really big on the, you know, hey, they've been planting seeds of this and this and time travel across like several of their books for several years now. And you know, it's going to be a big event in like maybe 2 years, 3 years. Marvel is patient with their big plans enough. Yeah. For something like that, and have gotten really, really good at coordinating lately. So,
I mean, I don't want to keep like hammering on WB and DC on what's going on, but I mean, even transitioning to like we're getting an awesome sequel with the Lego Movie, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, just to backtrack for a quick second, all us being said, Batman vs Superman could be legitimately awesome.
Oh yeah, no.
And it would alleviate all fears.
Yeah, Mike, that's the problem. At this point, they are setting their bar so freaking high.
This is like we have another what year before Marvel vs. No, we have 2 years before Batman Superman comes out, and so we're sitting here. We're like that guy, which is usually me, that's sitting there in line because you got that long, long wait in line for the roller coaster. And you just look at the roller coaster and you look at it so long to the point where you start looking at all the things that could go wrong with the roller coaster. We're sitting in line for the roller coaster and we have another year and a half to wait. So we're going to look at every way it can go wrong to the point where we're like, I don't know if I want to go on this ride.
Yeah, but that's the problem. That's what they are setting up for themselves. Nothing can go wrong from this point. But whatever, in terms of their IP, what they're doing on the television show is still keeping me engaged, and I like that. I just know that that doesn't transition to the movies, and they already were going up against Avengers, right? And they pulled their date back, and now they release this list. Batman vs. Superman has to be amazing,
I'm pretty sure DC is very glad that they pulled off of releasing the same day as Cap now.
Oh gosh, yeah.
Because Batman vs Superman versus Marvel's Civil War with the Black Panther, I know what I'm going to see.
I am not thrilled about seeing a Lego Batman movie, by the way.
No, that Lego Batman movie is going to be awesome. That's the only Batman movie I'm excited about. Have you played the video games, Malengo?
No, I haven't. I haven't played
the video games. You need to play the video games. That's why you're not excited about it. The Lego Batman video games are amazing. Legitimately funny. They don't take themselves seriously. Oh. On a screen that DC has done in years. It's so good. It's so, so good.
I'm just going to have to take your word on that.
You know what you should do? I believe on Netflix there is a Lego DC Superheroes movie.
Okay.
I believe it's on Netflix. Watch that. Because it's basically all the cutscenes from Lego Batman 2. It's really, really good.
All right, I'll go check that out. Moving along. Hey, so we actually have other stuff other than...